Kabisa, kabisa, kabisa mtazamaji. Saa moja ikiwa imekatika dakika 47. Unaendelea kunyonya tamu wa Art Culture Monday. Mahali ambapo tunakwambia tuko hapa kukujengea nchi vile ambavyo ungeitaka ikuwe tukitumia art. Hapo hivyo ndo nakwambia, kama ungetaka kusikiza msanii ambaye anaweza kuambia jinsi wewe kama binadamu unafaa kubehave kati ya binadamu mwingine, ujione wewe ni mtu na mwingine ni mtu, utasikiza msamaria mwema. Kama ungetaka kuappreciate kina dada, kama ungetaka kuwasaidia, kama ungetaka kupigana na jinsia za kithulma, unasikiza I Know a Woman. Thulma za kijinsia, unasikiza I Know a Woman, kwa sababu kila mtu anamjua mwanamke fulani, au amesikia kumhusu mwanamke fulani, au amemuona mwanamke fulani, au amesoma kuhusu mwanamke fulani ambaye amepitia thulma za kijinsia. Wewe unafaa kusikiza I Know a Woman. Niko hapa na muandishi wa I Know a Woman. Niko hapa na a legendary spoken word artist, jina lake Revolutionary Spita.
Yes, sir.
Habari ya asubuhi bro.
Nzuri sana,
shukuru. Tufanye hivi. Hadi before tuende kwa introduction yako. Tell them of a woman that you know.
Okay. I know a woman with an assault story. She wasn't wearing a clingy mini dress. She wasn't walking in a dark, dingy street. She had kept her skin discreet. I know a woman with an assault story. That wasn't a stranger she'd followed back into the house. It was 6 a.m. indoors. Did you expect a bra under her blouse? She'd felt safe under that same white roof before. How is she to know there's a red coating underneath? I know a woman with an assault story, and now she can't breathe. I know a woman with an assault story. Yet, she wasn't drunk that night. She didn't go out that night. She was with her besties that night. She says he was too strong for her to fight him off. She prays she grows strong enough to fight the trauma off her mind. I know a woman with an assault story, hoping refuge she'll find. I know a woman with an assault story. Her mother knows that story. Her father is not to know that story. If her father knows that story, her mother will be another woman I know with an assault story. I know one woman with two assault stories, and I'm not just adding salt to this story. I know a woman who knows a woman with an assault story, and she believes it can never happen to her. I know a woman who prays she never again hears of another woman with an assault story to refer. I know a woman with an assault story. Even after her video went viral, perpetrator has never stood trial. The police are looking for abstract evidence of physical abuse. I know a woman with an assault story who hopes her fate she could choose. I know a woman with an assault story. She never knew smiling at her customers was consent for married men who are never content. She was just riding the pole for bread, and then things went south. Now she has an extra mouth to feed come month 9. I know a woman with an assault story, and therapy has failed her countless times. She is tired of everyone telling her to open up a bottled up self whose corkscrew sits at the bottom of the sea. She is drowned. I know a woman with an assault story who believes she's forever damned. I know a woman with an assault story. She's 89. She's 78, she's 66, she's 54, she's 43, she's 32, she's 25, she's 12, she's 11 months old. I know a woman with an assault story, and it never gets old.
He knows a woman, anaitwa Revolutionary Spita. Wewe, you know a woman. Huyo woman anaweza kuwa your woman. Anaweza kuwa my woman. Ndio maana Revolutionary Spita anakumbusha kwamba 25th August this Sunday, that piece na zingine ambazo tutaongelelea leo kuhusu my Womine Experience.
Yes, sir.
Revolutionary Spita.
Yes, sir.
karibu.
Asante.
Katika Art and Culture.
Asante sana.
Iyo ndo pesa sasa. Tunaanza na moto.
Asante, asante.
Alafu tunauseta. Alafu Sunday 25th August. Tunawasha zaidi. Now I'm giving you a chance mazee.
Yeah.
Introduce wasalimie. Alafu. Wakaribishes tunaendelea.
Asante sana. Mimi naitwa Revolutionary Peter kama mlosikia. Mimi ni performing poet, writer, mimi pia ni actor kwa vipindi kadha wa kadha hapa na pale. Pia mimi hufunza watoto wadogo wa high school performing arts, drama pale, poetry nini nini. Yeah, basically mazee mimi ni creative tu, yani all around the space. Tukisukuma ile gurumu la usanii. Na karibu ni sana kwa Art and Culture Monday.
Kabisa, kabisa, kabisa. As in bro, nimekuwa nikikufuata. Nashangaa, we have a lot of talents in this country.
Yeah.
Na as in wale ni dogo, utapata, leo unapata huyu. Sasa ukidhani ushafika, huyu anakuintroduce
kwa mwingine.
Kwa mwingine. Na wote hawa wanaongea kuhusu the same things in kila mtu his unique way.
Mm-hmm.
Ama her unique way.
Mm.
And I love your ways, especially nyinyi wasanii wa spoken word.
Yeah.
Kwa sababu mna instill conscience ndani, especially kwanza mahali hakuna instrumentals.
Mm-hmm.
Ama instrumentals ni za kwa company tu.
Yeah, yeah.
Unajua kuna mziki unasikizaga, unasikizaga the beat, but lyrics ndio
kupita.
But sasa for spoken word, it's spoken word. Alafu utasini kidogo kidogo.
Mm.
Kazi imekuwa shwari. Sasa wewe experience imekuwaje since you started 2019?
Yeah, 2019
start na kazi imekuwaje spoken word?
Ilikuwa tu ilikuwa, maybe by accident nasema nikianza. Cause mimi sikuwa najua nafanya poetry. Nilikuwa tu naandika andika, also mimi nilikuwa big reader nikiwa form 1 form 2. So actually kuna msee alistumble upon rough book yangu na kaniambia hii kitu naduma zee, hii ni poetry bwana, hii ni spoken word. Back in Mombasa hapo hivyo, so nikaanzia pale. Then I came to Nairobi in 2019. At first industry kwa inaka wide. Mm. Yani everyone is new.
Mm.
Alafu watu ni wanoma mazee. Unaenda
mazee kila
mtu. Hey, mazee unaenda hivyo open mic mazee ni wanoma.
Ushaitokea birthday.
Mm.
After all unatokea KND.
Hey.
Unatokea gabo kijuaga minim. Bad.
Hata ni kushow.
Mm.
Many times ukona na hivi show. Nilikuwa na best yangu ito Alexis.
Mm.
Tunajuliza, hey bro, sisi kweli ni mapoet mazi. Mm. Tunajuliza ni,
yeah.
Tuwafa kurudi kwa drawing board. Yeah. Whatever guys are doing on stage.
Yeah.
Hey, unajua na mazeu kuchini.
Mm.
But what that did is, it made us want to get better and better and better. Mm. And write better.
Mm.
Go for workshops.
Mm.
Read more.
Mm.
So imekuwa tu a learning curve and a beautiful trajectory upwards.
Mm.
Tukijifunza sisi pia. Because nobody anainge industry yake unajua everything.
Mm.
Na pia tu curiosity ya kuwantu experiment.
Mm.
Ku take lessons and get better.
Mm.
So it's been quite the journey.
Ni mlima kupanda
na kupanda na kushuka.
It's more than roller coaster.
Yeah, yeah.
Sasa mka wewe na Lexus, you mean Lexus mshairi.
Yeah, that one.
So kama mmekuwa hapo hivyo mko pamoja, mli come up na idea ya mambo kama Rafink.
Yeah.
Rafinki, sasa uko hiyo collection ya wasanii na writers imekuwa ikiwasaidiaje? Mnaitumiagaje kama sako, kama chama kuguruisha, na mnafanyaga nini
katika wasako?
Alafu nimesikia mazee form 2 watu wengi wakinipigia experience zao za form 2. Wachana wala hiyo, lakini Kenya hao hizi shule zingine form 2 ndo yeye yao hataki anything to do with masomo, unaona. Ako tu barua. Sasa wewe badala ya barua wenzako wewe unaandika kitu. Hadi wenzako wanasema whatever you're doing
is something. Mm.
Rafiki imesaidiaje ku grow such talents and
kwanza Rafiki is a collective for writers and poets. Mm. As you know, and kitu important sana Rafiki tunafanya ni ku create your sense of belonging. Mm. And sense of community.
Mm.
Which kwa atitu ni very important.
Mm.
Ata wei believe you ukona community ya wenzako. Mm. Unye mnafanya the same thing.
Mm.
That's the same thing with Rafinki where tuna encourage yana ku get better in terms of writing. kwa group yetu siku wana prompts za at least kama ni ani kila mtu ni poet, yes, but the time spent uko chini, mm-hmm. I need to light up your flame, mm-hmm. So tunafanya hizo writing challenges, we do workshops, mm-hmm. we do open mics, so it gives you a sense of siko peke yangu, mm-hmm. niko na hawa, niko na haka kambogi, mm-hmm. you know, so hata kama saa kama vile nafanya show 25th, mm-hmm. Na tuko na Rafinki as a collective I belong in, mm-hmm. ni rahisi kuvutia one of them, eh, niaje maze, mm-hmm. I need help kitu fulani, mm-hmm. you know, we exist in the same circle, so it's either for them to pull strings for you, mm-hmm. Kukusaidia kumarket, mm-hmm. Also just even facilities, mm-hmm. Like kama uwe kuna microphone, uwe kuna kitu fulani, uwe kuna you need cast probably,
uwe kuna guitar,
uwe kuna guitar,
uwe anajua kupiga
so there's that collective
Talking about the community and all that, ukona peace umefanyia watu kwa community,
yeah.
Pengine si kila mama mzee anaweza fika pale ukumbi mdogo, 25th Sunday, but you will be celebrating them,
mm-hmm.
maybe for the youths pale hivyo wapeleke huu jumbe wazazi wao, mm. ama community yao,
mm.
ukona peace gani ya watu in the community ama jamii tunaweza dedicateia peace leo,
mm.
pia wao feel the heat, mm. wale ambao hawatapata enough today, basi uchukue tiketi tukutane na wao 25th August.
Sawa, so this goes out to our mothers, those who sang a dirge before they could sing a wedding song, or sang a dirge after singing a wedding song. Their lives are like a free Spotify account on shuffle. Song after song, hoping a lullaby would come by and put their nightmares to eternal sleep. This goes out to that campus girl who needs pills to sleep. This goes out to that campus girl who gets academic D's for rejecting a lecturer's D, and all her parents can think of is that asomi kwa bidii. Her esteem is bruised from all the undoing she's been accused. This goes out to that loving wife who is routinely abused. Yet her parents tell her to stick on because she's the magnet pulling them out of poverty. This goes out to all the women who've been sold out as property. A reminder that your value counts to infinity and you have no price. You are the goddamn prize. This goes out to all the women who getting verbally stabbed is no longer a surprise. This goes out to that neighbor who sheltered that crying woman that fateful night. You are a hero in your own right. This goes out to those of us who grew up in violent homes. How I pray your heavy hearts lead you to the light. This goes out to victims of madness, of gender hate, of bipolar partners, of marital rape. This goes out to all the people who from toxic environments are trying to escape. You are heroes, even without a cape. This goes out to all the men who fall in love with damaged women and walk with them through healing. To the men, understand that sometimes for a woman to feel safe around you beats all feelings. Your reward is in heaven. This goes out to our fathers who loved and did right by our mothers. This goes out to that woman and everyone doing something right for peaceful coexistence to redefine. This goes out to women.
Anawasha moto on Art and Culture Monday. Ladies and gentlemen, revolutionary spitter. Now, this goes out to wale wanauliza ni wapi unaweza perform live. Womine Experience will be happening this Sunday, this coming Sunday.
25th.
Sini hii Sunday?
Yeah, 25th.
Ni hii, 25th August at Kenya National Theatre, ukumbi mdogo.
Yes.
This goes out kwa mwenye anauliza ticket ni how much? 1,200. Lakini kama mko wengi ya group of 4, 2,500 pekee, mtaingia. This goes out to
Mwenye nauliza atanunua wapi. Eh. Kuna places mbili. Ya kwanza ni revolutionaryspeeder.hasusasa.com. Ama unaweza tumia till. Do, till ndo raisi.
Till ndo raisi.
Till ndo raisi. Eh. Till ni 900-7469. This goes out to mwenye nauliza isho ni gani. Eh. Art and Culture Monday.
Yes,
on sir. KUTV Rise Today.
Yes, sir.
Manze napenda hizi pieces.
Shukran.
Kuongea tu kweli wa Mungu. Can cheat, can die.
Shukran, shukran.
Design ya hii poster ya Woman's Experience. Mm. Ni mrembo. Lakini ame funikwa uso.
Mm.
Anaweza kuwa amefunikwa uso hapo kwa macho kabisa.
Mm.
Kwa sababu mbili zenye naona saizi.
Mm-hmm.
Pengine hataki kujulikana. Au sisi hatutaki ajulikane zaidi.
Yes.
Pengine anaficha kitu. Ni nini kili chochea ama kili sukumia sisi kukuwa na hii design,
poster design.
Poster.
As much as everyone knows a woman with an assault story, pia huwa kuna hiyo element ya ku hide their identity to protect them because sometimes the abusers tend to come back and want to to beat them again or to do something again. So that poster design imekuwa inspired from the aspect that tunajaribu ku protect identity ya umse. But pia ni ku onyesha that hawa sasa wengine wamefichika and they need to come out and that's what we're doing with this show, like putting it out there that one exists na need their our help collectively as a society, both as people, the systems in place need to like support that whole issue that we got to experience. So yeah, in a stem from that
kinadada aspect, yeah. Kina dada wameongelelewa sana.
Yeah.
Na lakini bado si feel kama society inajua mwanamke vizuri.
Mm.
That's why tunaweza kuwa na dem hapo but amefungua macho.
Mm.
Utasikia kama ni mahali kuna mambo na forensic evidences vitu kama hizo. Kuna vitu usemekana kama amefungua macho unaweza collect some data from.
Yes.
So watu wanaweza kuwa na pretend wanajua women sana. But they know nothing about them. They have so many stories that they have hidden in them.
Yes.
Na the only person anaweza wa understand fiti ni mwenye kona wake maybe. Womine. Sasa tunasikiza experience yako. Ya hiyo siko.
Napenda hiyo wordplay.
Hiyo wordplay kwa fiti.
Imeweza.
Tufanya hivi. Jiyo wordplay ni amazing kaa isho. Before to end the next, tusha wape info yote. Si wape PC ya amazing.
Sawa.
Sindiyo.
Uja wana wanga push lakini chini ya waji.
It's art and culture.
Hei nakubali.
Manze.
Daughter, when you're born, I hope you find street sanity a bit older than you. That the world will receive you as the angel you are and not as a child of a lesser god or the next contender of their punitive morality rod. Daughter, when you're 3, I hope the conductor doesn't heckle your mom keep under slow humor 3. Daughter, when you're 5 and joining school, I hope you find boy classmates that are cool. Boys who don't steal your lunch, pull your hair, or tear your shirt buttons in the name of child games. Super Mario is a child game. Daughter, when you're in grade 6, I hope you have learned to take the back seat. When in reproduction class, the rest of the class argues who's a stronger gender, just come home and argue with me about the climate change agenda. Daughter, when you're 13, I'll have 26 reasons why you shouldn't let a man accidentally touch you twice. And if any man lays a finger on you, I'll have them fed to wild mice. Daughter, when you're 18, I'll teach you that consent can either be verbal or written, not through your eyes, your dress, or any part of exposed skin that a no is an O, and anything else after a no is criminal, you know? I'll teach you how to stand on your own 2 feet before any man tries to sweep them away. I'll teach you how to fight for you nakikata, daughter, you fly away. Daughter, you're 25. I hope you have learned to stay alive. Because if strangers don't kill women, it's husbands that kill women, then I can only trust in depths of love the two of you will dive. And if you get sons, teach them that testosterone doesn't need violence to thrive. Daughter 29 and the virtue of divorce, please come home and start on a new course. There are 30 reasons why a man should feel like home. And if you can't find none outside, there's no shame in that man being me. With love, your daddy.
My goodness, revolutionary spitter on Art and Culture Monday.
Yes, sir.
Spitting wisdom, nothing else.